Hi, everyone. I'm Shravya, and I lead engineering teams exploring the cutting edge of AI in health. We want to help improve the health of billions of people across the globe, especially those in under-resourced environments, which is where we believe that AI can have a profound impact. Now, this work is very personal to me. I grew up in India, where timely access to care for people who live in hard-to-reach communities or villages that may have no hospitals can be seen as a luxury. And throughout my work here at Google, I've seen how technologies like AI can help bridge that gap and help save lives. Now, this is what motivates me and my team. For years now, we've been working on AI to help increase the accuracy and the access to screenings for life-threatening diseases, including tuberculosis, lung cancer, and breast cancer. And we have a deep history of working with our partners to understand how our technology might expand access to health services or improve the quality of care. For instance, can AI help improve how tuberculosis is diagnosed today and get people to the treatment that they need more quickly? So that's the question that we're trying to answer with our partner in India, Apollo Radiology International. And today, we're excited to share that Apollo will build upon our TB, lung, and breast cancer models to help diagnose more people sooner. So let's now zoom out and get a better understanding of the impact of these three diseases on people's health in the region. India has the highest burden of TB worldwide, with over 2 million cases reported each year. And the tragedy here is that there are many more cases that go undetected in the community because of a lack of access or timely intervention. And lung cancer is still one of the biggest causes of cancer mortality in India. Further, India has more than 3 times the death rate from breast cancer compared to the US. And for both of these diseases, screening rates across the country are very low. And there's a countrywide shortage of radiologists to interpret these scans. Now, I know these figures are staggering, but many of these deaths can be prevented. And we believe that AI has an important role here in helping more people receive diagnosis sooner and get life-saving treatment. Apollo is working towards bringing these models to markets across India. This means that with the required regulatory approvals, they can incorporate our algorithms into screening programs nationally. Additionally, over the next 10 years, Apollo will provide AI-powered screenings for TB, lung, and breast cancer in under-resourced communities at no cost. This will extend access and care to hundreds of thousands of people. Let's now take a deeper look at our work with Apollo and what AI-powered screens could mean for patients.
અમારું નામ છે ધારસીભાઈ નાનજીજી ઠાકોર. ખેતનું કામ કરે છે અને પશુપાલક સાથે કામ કરે છે. એટલે અમને ખાંસી આવતી હતી અને અંદરથી શ્વાસપણ એમ સડતું એવું થતું હતું અને શક્તિ કમ પડતી હતી, વજન ઘટી જતું હતું, જણો જણો તાવ રહેતો અમારે, આમાં તકલીફ બહુ થતી. અમારું પશુપાલકનો અને અમારા છોકરાનો અને અમારા પત્નીનો આ પાછળ શું થાય એવું પછી અમે રિપોર્ટ ઘટાડ્યો. નજીકમાં ધાનેરા જઈ ધાનેરાવાળા ડૉક્ટર કાંઈ રિપોર્ટ બતાવ્યો એટલે ધાનેરાવાળા સાહેબે કીધું કે તમારે આવી રીતે છે આમાં કે.
My name is Dr. Srinivas Raju Kalidindi. My father was a doctor. He was the only physician for the entire village. But all he had was a stethoscope and a microscope. There was no technology of any kind. So he saved a lot of lives. So that is the reason in my decision to become a doctor and also become a radiologist. India is a country that has about a quarter of world's TB burden. Approximately 1.3 million people died of TB in 2022. Under 400,000 were deaths in India.
Good afternoon, everyone.
So I'm going to be talking today about TB.
TB is an airborne disease. It enters the lungs and it can cause infection within the lungs. It can cause cavities, it can cause abscesses, It can cause accumulation of fluid around the lungs, and it can spread to other organs, and in some cases can be fatal. If TB is treated promptly with medication, the lungs can become healthy again and the patient will be cured. It is not acceptable for a curable disease to kill so many people in the modern age.
I've been at Google now for a long time, over 16 years. And for the last 6 years, I've been working pretty much exclusively at this intersection of health and AI. We've been partnering with Apollo Hospital and Dr. Raju and his team for several years now. We have an effort in the use of AI to detect tuberculosis from chest x-rays as a means of triaging. We need solutions that could be scalable and are cost-effective so that you could then detect tuberculosis early enough and thus reduce the spread in communities. And for the case of AI for chest x-ray solutions, it felt like a great fit.
One really good example of how AI can be used is having a van going into the villages with an X-ray machine on board. The patients can come, have a screening done, and then also have their X-ray done. And the X-ray will then be transmitted to a central location where AI can give an immediate interpretation about the likelihood of TB. And this interpretation will later be confirmed by a radiologist. It will act as an aid to the radiologist so that they can make the diagnosis more quickly and more effectively.
ત્યાં ગામમાં મળતા બધી સગવડ એટલે અમારે આગળ જવાની જરૂર નથી જલ્દી અમારું નિદાન થાય.
My father had a lot of patients who had TB. If he had access to something like this, I'm sure he would have been able to treat a lot more patients with TB and probably save a lot of lives. My father would have been extremely excited.
Beyond using AI to support early diagnosis, our research teams have also been using AI to improve the accuracy and reduce the cost of genome sequencing. Genetic heritability is responsible for 30% of a person's health outcomes, but in practice, it's hardly used to guide disease prevention and care. Sequencing genomes enables us to identify variants in a person's DNA that indicate genetic disorders, such as an elevated risk for breast cancer. And we have a long history of developing open source software for applications to improve the accuracy and the speed of genetic sequencing. One such example is our deep variant method, which accurately finds genetic variants in sequencing data. It was even used to identify disease-causing variants for newborns in record time. Genetic conditions affect nearly 6% of births, but clinical sequencing tests to identify these conditions can take days or weeks to complete. So we partnered with Stanford to study the use of deep variant to help identify suspected disease-causing variants in critical NICU cases. In the fastest cases, a likely disease-causing variant was identified in as little as 8 hours after sequencing began. Now think of the potential this has in getting babies to the treatment that they need more quickly. And more recently, Deep Consensus and Deep Variant, our open source sequence analysis tools, have been important contributions to an effort called the Human Pangenome Project. This has created a new human reference genome that contains the sequences of multiple individuals of diverse ancestries. The first draft of the human genome was completed back in 2003. And while it was a huge scientific breakthrough, it was created almost entirely based on one man who responded to a newspaper ad. And needless to say, that does not capture much diversity. The Human Pangenome Project is the largest step taken to date in developing a reference genome that truly represents everyone. It features 47 genome sequences pulled from people all over the world. And we recently released an open source genomics pipeline for the scientific community to use the pangenome in their analysis. Now, this is a big deal because the point of a reference genome is to serve as a standard of sorts. People from underrepresented backgrounds have a higher rate of undiagnosed or misdiagnosed diseases. So scientific discovery and drug development should be based on a reference genome that is truly representative of everyone everywhere. There is so much potential here for AI and genomics research to unlock new learnings about genetics and diseases. And our contributions to these scientific efforts can help development of new treatments and a much more complete understanding of biology.